Hello students, let us see today's class about periodic function. Today we are discussing still periodic function problems. After this periodic function problems, we will start Leibniz rule. Okay. Next week we are going to finish this chapter. Now let us see a periodic function. You have a question like integration 0 to 100 fraction part of x dx is how much? We have another question, integration of minus 3 pi to 200, 10, fractional part of 2x dx is how much. I am going to give today some shortcuts for this. First, let me explain the method, then after I give the shortcuts. Now, if I want to find the integration 0 to 100 f of fractional part of x, all you know the graph of fractional part of x. What is the graph of fractional part of x? I think 10 to 20 times I revise this. So this is the graph of fractional part of x. This is the graph of fractional part of x. And you know this is y is equal to 1. This is 0, 1, 2, and this is going on in this way, right? All of you know this is the graph of fractional part of x. Correct? This is the fractional part of x. What is the period of fractional part of x? The period of fractional part of x is, the period of this function is 1. You know very well. So, I can write this one as, this question I can write as, integration 0 to 100 into period of the function. Means we have to express this into period into the number. So, the 100 into 1 we can write because the period is 1. If the period is 2, we write 50 into 2. As yesterday I discussed some problems based on this. We have done many problems yesterday. Still we are doing better problems based on periodic function. Let's see here how to do it. So period of this function is 1. So I can write integration 0 to 100 into 1 fractional part of x dx. So what is this is going to happen? This is going to get as, yesterday I gave the formula, so 100 will come back, 100 into integration 0 to 1 in fractional part of x dx. Now my question is, 0 to 1 means here, 0 to 1, in this is the branch, 0 to 1. If this branch is different, then things will be changed. If I say 2 to 3, that is the difference of opening the fractional part of x. You already know this is x. You know here x minus 1, this is x minus 2, this is x minus 3, this is x plus 1, branches already discussed. If the interval is minus 1 to 1, if the interval is minus 1 to 0, I will open this fractional part of x is x plus 1. But the interval is 0 to 1, in this case, I will open this fractional part of x with x. So, I can write 100 into integration 0 to 1 x dx. That I can write as 100 into. What is the integration of x? Integration of x is x square by 2. So, we write as x square by 2. I just substitute the limits 1 and 0. What I am going to get here, 100 into, this is, I can write this one. If I substitute 1, 1 square by 2 minus 0, if I substitute 0 square by 2, that is 0. I am substituting the upper limit and lower limit in this function. So finally my answer is 100 by 2, that is 50. This is the way to do integration of fractional part of x. Then what is about a fractional part of 2x? The interval is given minus 3 by 2 to 100, 10. How can you do this, sir? Let's see here how to handle this type of question. Today we are discussing about periodic functions and Leibniz rule. Let's see here this one, how can we write? Minus 3 by 2, 2, this is given. 2x is given. Given 2x. This is the fractional part of x graph. What is the graph of fractional part of 2x then? The graph of fractional part of 2x will be like this. This is the x-axis and this is the y-axis. Here we write as 0 and this is what we can write as, this is not going to get 1. 2x is equal to 1, x is equal to half. So you get here half. You get here half. Why? Because here it is 2x and here is x. Here is x. So if you have x, then the period of the function is 1. If you have 2x, what is the period of the function? 1 by 2. If the fact, if it is there 3x, then the period is 1 by 3. Already in functions, I explained you periodic functions and the period of the function. The period of this one is 1 by 2. Correct. If it is 1 by 2, what is the next one? That is 1. Right. Then you get 1. Next one will be how much? Tell me. So here you get like this, 1 plus 1 by 2, that is how much? 3 by 2. Next will be 3 by 2. Hope you understand. Here, coming back, here is minus 1 by 2. Next one will be minus 1. Next one will be how much? Next one will be how much? Minus 3 by 2. Look at here. This is the lower limit, minus 3 by 2. To where it is going? 10. It is going to 10. Let's say the graph of the function will be same. The graph will be like this. This is the graph of fractional part of x. This is the graph of fractional part of x. This is the graph of fractional part of x. And what will be this? This will be what? See, this is the graph of fractional part of x. Here, when you have this one, the period is 1. And here, the period will be half. So this will be half. This will be half. Till it is goes half. This is the value of half. Y is half. Here is y is 1. Hope you understand. So if here is the y is half, so how we can do it? Deal this. The period is half. Understand? So what we can write, the graph of this function is becoming like this. But my thinking is, how many strips, I mean, how much period it will repeat it. See here, when I have like this, this is 100 times this period. Period is 1, this is the period is 1. When 0 to 100, if you count, the same branch will repeat, like this branch. This branch will repeat, this branch will repeat. This branch from 0 to 100 is repeat how many times? 1, 2, 3, 4. Counting 100 times it is repeat. That is the number of strips we call. Now if it is there, minus 3 by 2, 10, how many times the strips will be repeat? That is my question. Hope you understand when 0 to 100 is there, this fractional part of x repeats 100 times because the period is 1. But when you have minus 3 by 2 to 10, how many times the strip is repeats? That you should know. Let's see here, from 0 till 0, how many parts it is repeating? 1, 2, 3. Till 0 it is repeating 3 times. Then it is half, 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 till 10, in the positive 0 to 10, how many times it repeats? The strip is how many times repeats? That is 20 times repeats. From here it is repeat 20 times. And here you have 3 times. Totally how many times it is repeat? 23 times. So this is going to be changed. This is going to be changed. What I can write here, integration, if I can write this one as, this is I can write as integration. I can write this one as 0 to, this is I can write as 0 to 23. Can I write 0 to 23? Because if these strips are repeating 23 times. So if I find one strip area, and I multiply 23 times, that is the result yesterday I explained here properly. So what I want to say here 23 times it is repeats. And the greatest, the fractional part of x will be same. Y is equal to x, y is equal to f of x. Here is 0 to half will be same, it is repeats, comes same. Right. So what I am going to get here, f of 2x, what a integration of, sorry, fractional part of 2x, how it is open. That is important. Okay, understand what I said. So you understand, right? Understood, no? So what I am going to get, this is going to happen in 2x it comes. Okay, because you know already this is x, that means that is 2x, correct? Then what is the integration of 2x, 3x? Then let's look at that and see that. What I can write here, 0 to 1, I can, 0 to, then I can write as, how much 2x will, 2 comes out, 0 to 23. And what is the x integration? Integration of x dx, I'll get x dx. That is 2 integration of x is x square by 2. I can substitute 23 and 0. What is I get 2 into 23 whole square by 2. Correct? Minus 0. 2 cancel. Okay, hope you understand. See here. Actually, this yesterday I explained you property. No? According to the property, you have to do. Right? 2 integration. 2 times 2 came out, integration 0 to 23 x dx. But period is important, right? What is the period? Period is half. So what can I write here? I can write this one as 2 into 23 times fits 0 to period x dx. This is the correct one. Actually, what I want to write as 0 to half 23 times. Half. Actually, this is I have to write 0 to half. Correct? I have to write 0 to half 23 times x dx. That is the way we have to write. Okay. Okay, we can write like this. Directly we can write here. 23 times. We can write actually the way is minus 3 by 2 is repeating 23 times. So we write as 23 times. We write as integrate 23 times half. 0 to half. Period. 0 to half is the period. How many times? 23 times of the function. Function is 2x. That is the way to write. So what I can write here? This is right. This is wrong. This is wrong. What I have write here? 23 times. I will write as 23 times. 23 into 2. 23 into 2, 46. 23 into 2, that is 46 times. Integration 0 to half dx. Now, I can write as 23 into 46. So, 46 integration x is x square by 2. And I can substitute 1 and 0. That is 46 into, if I substitute here, what I get here? 1 by 2 whole square. 1 by 2 whole square divided by 2 minus 0 if I substitute 0 square by 2. Right, I get this. So 46 into 1 by 2 whole square, that is 1 by 4. 1 by 4 into 2, that is 1 by 8. And you can simplify this one. You can simplify 24 table, you can do it. Otherwise 2 table, 2 table, 2 to the 2. 2 to the 4. 2, 3 is a 6 upon 23 by 4 is the answer. I repeat once again, here is the problem. When you have minus 33 by 2 to 10, fractional part of 2x dx, the dealing of this question is, how many steps it is repeating I have checked. Because the period is half. If the period is half, the steps are repeating how many? That are 23 repeating. Because here is 3, here is 20. Totally it is 23. So I can write the area is 1 period into 23 I can write. 23 into this period. So 23 into integration of 1 period. That is this area into 23 if I multiply over. So this area into 23. The two actually f of x is equal to, in this case, f of x you get. Y is equal to f of x means here you get y is equal to 2x I get. Because this is half function, 2x function. This is a 2x function, you will get 2x. Here you get 2x minus 1. Here you get 2x minus 2. Here you get 2x plus 1. Right? So this is the way you get. If you don't know, already I explained you, slope of the function is 1. And the point you can take 0, comma how much? Here you can see, substitute here 0. 0, comma 0. And then you substitute as formula wise, you will get the answer. However, you have got like this 2x. Then what I get here, 23 into 46 and I just integrated, so you got the answer. So this is the way to do it. I'll give the shortcut also. Okay, hope you understand.